Section 1. A shadow his father makes with joined hands and thumbs and fingers nibbles on the wall like a rabbit's head. He understands, he will understand more when he goes to school. There, he draws smoke with chalk the whole first week, then draws the fork stick that they call away. This is writing. A swan's neck and swan's back make the two we can see now as well as say. Two rafters and a cross tie on the slate are the letter some call A, some call A. There are charts, there are headlines, there is a right way to hold a pen and a wrong way. First, it is copying out, and then English, marked correct with a little leaning hold. Smells of ink wells rise in the classroom hush. A globe in the window tilts like a colored O. Section 2. Declension sang an air like a hosanna, as column after stratified column, book 1 of Elementa Latina, marbled and miniature, rose up in him. For he was fostered next in a stricter school, named for the patron saint of the Oakwood, where classes switched to the pealing of a bell, and he left the Latin Forum for the shade of new calligraphy that felt like home. The letters of this alphabet were trees. The capitals were orchards in full bloom. The lines of script like briars coiled in hitches. Here, in her snooded garments and bare feet, all wrinkled in assonance and wood notes, the poet's dream stole over him like sunlight and passed into the tenebrous thickets. He learns this other writing. He is the scribe who drew a team of quills on his white field. Round his cell door, the blackbirds dart and dab. Then, self-denial, fasting, the pure cold. By rules that harden the farther they reach north, he bends to his desk and begins again. Christ's sickle has been in the undergrowth. The script grows bare and Merovingian. Section 3. The globe has spun. He stands in a wooden O. He alludes to Shakespeare. He alludes to graves. Time has bulldozed the school and school window. Bailers draw bales like printouts, where stooped sheaves made lambdas in the stubble once at harvest, and the delta face of each potato pit was patted straight and molded against frost. All gone, the omega that kept watch above each door, the good luck horseshoe. Yet, shape note language, absolute on air, as Constantine's sky-lettered in hoc signal can still command him, or the necromancer who would hang from the domed ceiling of his house a figure of the world with colors in it, so that the figure of the universe and not just single things would meet his sight when he walked abroad, as from his small window the astronaut sees all that he has sprung from the risen, aqueous, singular, lucent O, like a magnified and buoyant omen.
Broken Dreams by W.P. Yeats. There is gray in your hair. Young men no longer suddenly catch the breath when you are passing. But maybe some old gaffer mutters a blessing because it was your prayer recovered him upon the bed of death. But your soul saved that all hearts ache have known, and given to others all hearts ache. From meager girlhood putting on burdensome beauty, for your soul's sake, heaven has put away the stroke of her doom. So great her portion in that feast you make by merely walking in a room. Your beauty can but leave among us vague memories, nothing but memories. A young man, when the old men are done talking, will say to an old man, "Tell me of that lady," the poet stubborn with his passion sanguis, when age might well have chilled his blood. Vague memories, nothing but memories, but in the grave, all shall be renewed. the certainty that I shall see that lady leaning or standing or walking in the first loveliness of womanhood, and with the fervor of my youthful eyes had set me muttering like a fool. You are more beautiful than anyone, and yet your body had a flaw. Your small hands were not beautiful, and I am afraid that you will run and battle to the wrist in that mysterious, always brimming lake with those that have obeyed the holy law, battles and other lake. Leave and change the hands that I have kissed for old sake's sake. The last stroke of midnight dies. All day in the one chair, from dream to dream and rhyme to rhyme, I have ranged. In rambling talk with an image of air, vague memories, nothing but memories. Thank you.
Whatever you say, say nothing. By Seamus Heaney. I'm writing this just after an encounter with an English journalist in search of views on the Irish thing. I'm back in winter quarters where bad news is no longer news, where media men and strangers sniff in coin, where zoom lenses, recorders and coil leaves litter the hotels. The times are out of joint, but I incline as much to rosary beads as to the jottings and analysis of politicians and newspaper men who have scribbled down the long campaign from gas and protest to Gaelic night in Sten, who grouped upon their pulses, escalate, backlash and crackdown. The provisional wing, polarization and long-standing hate. Yet, I live here. I live here too. I sing. Expertly civil tongue with civil neighbors on the high wires of first wireless reports, sucking the fake taste, the stony flavors of those sanctioned old elaborate retorts. Oh, it's disgraceful, surely, I agree. Where's it going to end? It's getting worse. They are murderers, internment, understandably. The voice of sanity is getting hoarse.
Trees are in their autumn beauty, the woodland paths are dry. Under the October twilight, the water mirrors a still sky. Upon the brimming water, among the stones, are 9 and 50 swans. The 19th autumn has come upon me since I first made my count. I saw, before I had well finished, all suddenly mount and scatter between great broken rings upon their clamorous wings. I have looked upon those brilliant creatures, and now my heart is sore. All changed since I, hearing at twilight, the first time on the shore, the bell beat of the wings above my head, draws with a lighter tread. Unwearied still, lover by lover, the adult and the gold, companionable streams of climb the air, their hearts have grown, not grown cold. Passion or conquest, wander where they will, attend upon them still. But now they drift on the still water, mysterious, beautiful. Among what rushes will they build? By what lake's edge or pool delight men's eyes when I awake someday to find they have flown away? Thank you.
An Irish airman, Horses is Dead by W.B. Yeats. I know that I shall meet my fate somewhere among the clouds above. Those that I fight, I do not hate. Those that I guard, I do not love. My country is picked out in cross. My countrymen picked out in spoor. No likely end could bring them loss or leave them happier than before. Nor law, nor duty bade me fight. Nor public men, nor cheering crowds. A lonely impulse of delight drove to this tumult in the clouds. I balanced all, brought all to mind. The years to come seemed a waste of breath of years behind. It balanced with this life, this death. Thank you.